Configuring the SharePoint server farm is the next step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services cloud. You should have already launched the network, Active Directory, database application, and web front-end stacks for SharePoint, as demonstrated in the previous videos in this series. This video outlines the tasks involved in configuring the SharePoint server farm on AWS. While SharePoint on AWS supports many different kinds of deployment, this configuration creates a public-facing website for a proof of concept or a demo. The companion document gives a high-level outline of these procedures. Begin configuring the SharePoint farm by connecting to the application server, App 1, with remote desktop connection. First, install SharePoint from the /SharePoint_install directory. Then run the SharePoint products configuration wizard and create a new SharePoint farm. Next, connect to Web Frontend Server 1, WFE1, with remote desktop connection. Again, install SharePoint from the /SharePoint_install directory. Then run the SharePoint products configuration wizard and connect to the new farm. On the farm, launch the SharePoint farm configuration wizard and create a site collection. Finally, connect to Web Frontend Server 2, WFE2, with remote desktop connection. Again, install SharePoint from the /SharePoint_install directory. Then run the SharePoint products configuration wizard and connect to the new farm. After that, you can connect to the team site from within the Contoso domain using the URL of the new site, http://app1. The Advanced Implementation Guide provides detailed step-by-step instructions to guide you through the minimum setup steps to configure a functional public-facing website on a SharePoint farm. Now your SharePoint public-facing website is ready for users and content. The next step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services cloud is to estimate the costs of running the sample site.